All right. So why identifying community needs? I choose this honor because I am one of the leaders who really enjoy and who really love to go out. Before being involved in Pathfinders, I was involved in mission, and I think it's really, really important to know exactly what are the needs of our community. And when I refer to our community, please remember I refer to where we live, not to where our church is based at. Even the presentation, it's a bit general. It's not as focused as I wanted in the beginning to be. On the end of the presentation, I hope you guys will learn and will be sure how to help your community. The reason for that is because usually we live far away from the church. So if your case is that you live very close to the church and your Adventist community lives very close for the church, then it's fine to do this identification in your area. But if you live far away from the church and then you go to the church from time to like you have to travel 20 kilometers or you have to take the car or it's really hard to you, then the community is specifically where you live. Okay, now let's see what the honor says. Now this is more, I really like the action honors. So this is one of the honors I like because it's action based. So the first, now I'm just going to present what are the requirements. You don't have to write anything down yet. The worksheets, they were posted on the BUC website. So you should get them and I hope you have them. They are not hard to be filled. So the first requirement is to read Matthew chapter 9 from verse 35 to 38. We'll go very soon into it. Then we need to select an area. I already said a few things about it. I'm going to go and take each one of the points one by one. The third one is to prepare a file of the area, and I'm going to tell you what it needs to go in that file. Then awareness the area. We need to know that area and we need to learn a few things about it. Now we need to check if what we think is what the community really needs. And the last one is to share your research. So Matthew chapter 9, verse 35. I hope you have the Bibles with you. Actually, I can't see you guys and I can't understand why. I see only the presentation and I can't see you. Okay, so I hope you have the Bibles. Pastor Dan, I need you to be my eyes. If you can. Okay, so if you have your Bibles open, can you hear me?
Yes, we can, Bogdan.
Yeah, all right. So if you have your Bibles open, Pastor Dan, can you please ask for Pathfinders? I don't know why I can't see the screen with the Pathfinders.
Okay.
So if you can ask four people to read, four Pathfinders to read one verse each.
If anybody would like to read the text, please put a hand up, guys. Just unmute yourself and start reading, guys. So Matthew 9, 35 to 38, we would need the Pathfinder to read this for us. Okay, here it is. We can have Romeo, just unmute yourself and start reading.
I just read.
Okay, we are ready for you, Romeo. Just read it for us.
Sorry.
Oh, Bungie, would you like to read? You just start reading, Bungie. Unmute yourself.
So it says Jesus paid little attention to what the Pharisee said, but continued on his way, stopping at all the cities and villages in the area, teaching in the local synagogues, preaching the good news of the kingdom and healing every sickness and disease the people had.
Okay. Bogdan, was that what you needed?
Not really, because it is on the screen.
Okay. And then, Romeo, if you want to read the text 36.
Okay. 36. But when he saw the multitudes, he was moved by compassion for them, because they were weary and scattered, like sheep having no shepherd.
Okay. Thank you, Romeo, for that. And Helen, if you wouldn't mind reading 37.
And he said to his disciples, the harvest truly is plentiful, but the laborers are few.
And Helen, just read for 38 for us as well.
Therefore pray the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest.
Excellent. Thank you so much, guys. You've done a top job. Love it.
Well done. Okay. Thank you. So just a quick question, and please write it down on the chat. So after the reading from what Jesus did, right? What do you think the needs of our community are? So,
all right, question for all of us, guys. Bogdan posed, after reading the Bible and what Jesus did, what do you think, guys, what a community needs are? Please use your chat. We would like to know that. And, you know, as we all live in some certain community. So Romeo writes down and he says, love, compassion, and care. We need that in our communities. Let's hear people on the Facebook. If you do have a comments, please do write it in the comment section. But people are saying, you know, people need a garden community as well, salvation. Bogdan, that's some of the answers. And I will share more when they come in. So if you continue then.
All right. Thank you. So they need this stuff, but they might need other stuff as well. All right. Let's see. So we are going to the requirements, and the second requirement was to select an area. What that means to select an area? I'll give you an example. Actually, I'm going to give you two examples. The first example comes from England, which is in 2013, London was chosen to be one of the mission to the cities, and it was loads of action happening in London for a while. And then the other example is coming from the Adventist Community Services from Dublin, and this is happening now. It's a project which is running. I would love to see and to know that the mission from the cities action from London in 2013 is still follow up. But I'm not going to go into that. So select an area. What area can you select? You can select, for example, I don't know, I live in Selbridge. So the village I live is Selbridge. So I can select Selbridge, which I already did. And after you select the area, after you select the location where you want to serve the community, we will need to do the next steps. So for you, an area can be your neighborhood, it can be your estate where you live, it can be the church area. So whoever lives near the church, this is the area. And this is what we mean by selecting an area. You select a location where you want to serve the community. Okay, is that clear? If that's clear, please say yes on the chat so I can go forward. Yes, Okay, yes, it is clear. All right, thank you, guys. Now, create a file of the area. Now, what that mean? That means we need to start to do some research of that location. So, some locations you may know really well. If is, I don't know, if is your estate, or if is your town or your village, you might know that village really well, and it can be really, really easy for you. For example, for me, it was really hard when I was involved in mission to the cities in London, because I don't know London. And I was in different places and I couldn't make the difference between them. So that's why it's really important to choose an area which is accessible to us and which is easy. So what the file should have? A map first. It should have a demographic profile. I'll go and I'll take them one by one and I'm going to explain them to you. A public health statistic, an economic indicators, housing information, and environment and transportations. We are going to take them one by one, right? So for requirement number three, you need to create a file. And in that file, you have to make a bit of research of the location you choose, okay? So let's see, a map. Now, this is a map from which I got from Google for London, but doesn't really apply. Let's say if I live in Selbridge or Southampton, for example, because I've seen someone on the chat gave an example about Southampton. You are going to take a map of Southampton from Google, and you put that map in your file. It's very important to know the streets, to know the area, to know who lives there, what shops are there, what churches are there, and stuff like that. So the first thing we choose, we download and we file the map of the location we choose to work in, okay? Now, the second one is a demographic profile. Basically what that means, I know it's a fancy word, sometimes it's hard for me to read it. So you are interested to know in your location what type of people live. For example, I think this was for Greater London. So you see the Greater London residents. We have an Indian community, a Middle East community, a reminder of Asia. We have some Australasia. We have some EU people which are living in Greater London. We have some Americans and we have some Africans. So why is that important to know what kind of people live in that location? Is because they come from different cultures. They have different mentalities, different way of thinking. And we need to understand each and one of them because none of them will be the same, right? So we need to know what kind of people are living in that area. Is that clear?
Yes, it is, Bogdan. Yes, it is.
All right. Okay, thank you. Now, the next thing is the public health statistics. So for the same location, we are interested to see what kind of, I don't know, what kind of diseases are really common in that area. Because what we are looking for, we are researching to see how can we help those people. So for example, if 2.2% are diabetes, that means we can organize for those people some workshops where we can teach them what to eat and how to eat and how to live a healthy lifestyle and so on. So all those informations are very important for us to understand what are the needs of that location. How can we answer to those people's needs? And the other thing is to help us to choose what approach to take. So if the location, in that location, there are many people who are sick, it means that they need someone to teach them how to live. So we are going to use a health approach. And for example, if economic indicators, if it's a poor area, so for example, maybe they are not sick, but they are poor. They don't have jobs. They are on the social welfare. And I don't know, if it's a poor area, then their need will be clothes, food, I don't know, jobs, you know? So it's really important to see what kind of people are living there, where are they coming from, are they healthy or not? And the next one is, are they poor? Are they rich? Are they middle? Housing information. Do they own the houses? Do they live in, in social houses which are given by the state? Do they own the houses? All this information is really important, because what we want to do is to make an idea. We want to make the profile of the people who are living in the location we choose. Okay? All right. The next one is environment and transportation. Why is that important? For example, where I live in Selbridge, if I would have this location to concentrate on and to answer to my local community needs, and then I will need help from the church. So I would need to know how many people are living in the area from my church, so they can help me. Because it's important to have someone to help you. You won't be able to do all the things by yourself. This is a teamwork. And how can they come to my place? Can they use the bus? Can they use the train? Can they use the luas? Do they need to walk? This is really important, because when we choose a location, we need to get access to it really quick. We don't need to travel a lot. We have to go there quick, and it has to be very easy, accessible. In my place, for example, in Selbridge, where we started Pathfinder Community Club, which means the Pathfinders in the club are from the community, they are not from the church. I am helped by teens from my church, from the Dublin Romanian church, and some of them are driving, some of them are coming by bus, and I have none which is coming by train, but the train is there, so it's easy accessible, and everybody can get to my place easily. So this is one of the things you have to bear in your mind. How would you get to that area? If you choose the church area and you have to go to the church, then how would you get there? It is easy to get there. Do you have to drive 40 minutes? Do you have to drive 5 minutes? Or can you take a bus? Or, you know, you have to have all those things in your mind. So that's why it's really important to put all this information in a file. Because you will need to do something with this file on the end. And I'm going to explain to you when we get there. Okay. The fourth requirement is awareness of the area. What does that mean? For example, for me, I had plans to go with my club in Selbridge, in the village, to have a walk and to observe. Basically, you don't need to do something really cool. You just walk and you observe. You observe carefully. You look what are the needs of your community. This is what you are looking for. For example, if you have a walk in the, I don't know, in the village and you see loads of garbage on the street, that's a need. Basically, what you can do, you can take your club for a weekend, I don't know, for Sunday or for a Monday or for whatever, and just clean the area. Having your scarves, they are really important because people, they need to know where are you coming from, and organize one day to clean that area. Or if you are walking and you see that many of the people living there are old, they might have other needs. So if they are old, you can do something else, but I'm going to tell you what when we'll get there. So it's really important, as the requirement four says, to go in that area and to identify what needs you think the community have. For example, and I'm going to share with you, I think, two videos on this slide. One comes from 2013 and one comes from 2021 in two different cities. One, it's London. Now you'll see the video. It was done in Newbold College. And the other one, it's on the streets of Dublin. So if you know it already, it's fine. If not, we are not going to watch it all. We are going to watch only the part we are interested in. And that part is identifying the needs, is the awareness of the area.
So I walked into this coffee shop the other day and I ordered my hot drink. I sat down in a corner of the coffee shop, took out my book, and just needed some time out, so I started to read. About 10 minutes went in and the door of the coffee shop opened, and then this lady walked in. She looked kind of flustered and tired, and she ordered her chai latte, sat down on a table pretty much next to mine. She herself picked out her book and started to read as well. And that was fine. About 5 minutes passed by and my eyes lifted and I started to look at this lady. It was very interesting because I caught this lady doing something. She had her book in her left hand, her chai latte in her right, and she just stared into space. You ever had those moments where you just, you're lost into another world, but you don't actually realize that you're staring into space? You just do it and you kind of catch yourself doing it. It was one of those moments. And as she looked deep into another world, it was almost like she felt this edge of serenity, like she was so deeply content. How do I know? Well, as I was watching her, I saw this smile come on her face. It wasn't a smile as in she remembered something that was funny. It was a smile of peace, of happiness. I mean, I don't know anything about this lady. Maybe she's got 2-3 kids, a husband. Maybe she's been shopping all day. But whatever it was, she managed to get away from the hustle and bustle of life, sit down in this coffee shop, and experience peace. Then...
Okay, so it's enough. And the other need, what do you see? Okay, Romeo says on the chat, to be aware of your surroundings so you are able to solve the problems and find the most needed needs of the area. That's exactly what I mean. This picture was done in Dublin in late November 2020. And what can you see? In 2020, you have a small child with no shoes. In one of the best countries to live in Europe, right? Or this is something else. You have people on the streets who sleep on the streets. So you see, there are two kinds of needs. You have a spiritual need, but then it's a physical need as well. So our calling as a church, as Pathfinders, is to help our communities and to answer them to the both of those needs. Okay? Now, for requirement number 4, I think you just need to write down what you observe in your church, so in your local area, where you choose to work. So you go around, you write down what have you noticed or what have you seen. After you did that, you go to the next step. Because sometimes what we believe the community needs, it's not really the same with what community needs. So we might think, oh, they need Jesus. Yes, they need Jesus, but before that they are naked and we need to give them clothes, or they don't have food, so we need to give them food. And after we give them food, they will be able to take the spiritual food as well. So the requirement number 5 says, check the needs of the community. So there are two ways. Actually, there are three ways. The third option, it's on the next slide. So the first one is invite a civic leader or community professional to make a presentation to your Pathfinder Club. So basically you go, you ask the TD, which is the, I don't know, this is how they are called in Ireland. So the local politician, or someone who's involved in the community, I don't know, the community leader, because it should be someone. And you ask him to make a presentation, if he's able to do a presentation of the community needs in your Pathfinder Club. So this is one of the way. The other way is you to go where he is and you ask him. So basically you ask for an appointment with your civic leader, and on that appointment, you ask him, look, we are from the Pathfinder Club and we want to be more involved in community, and we want to help you to answer to the community needs. So can you give us some hints on what are the community needs in this location, and the location being the one you are researching, okay? And the third one is what we actually, in the mission to the cities, because I was involved in London, we did the third one. Actually, we did a bit of all of them, because we targeted different areas in London. So in one area, we did the first option. In another area, we did the second option. And in one of the areas, we did the third option, which was we went into the local, you have a local shop or I don't know, like a small shopping center. And we spoke with the leaders of the shopping center, and we said, look, we want to be involved in the community. And in order to answer the community needs, we would like to organize a small survey in the shopping center to see what the community says they needs are. So what we did, we had a nice banner, we had a small table, and we had a few surveys, and then we had the pinch tables. It's like a table or something, and you pinch what you have to do in them, like a note I don't know how it's called, a wall note thing where you put notes on the wall. And that was for the community, for the people from community to write down what they would love to see changing in their community. And they had to ping that in this world. Okay, bye, no problem. No problem, Romeo. And so we did that. Those three things we did. And I'm telling you, the results were unbelievable. I'm going to share some of the results with you in a few minutes. So is this clear? Yeah. So, all right. So if this is clear, we go to the next requirement, which says share your research. So after you choose the location, after you choose the location, after you file all the things, map and all the stuff about the area, after you made the awareness, after you work actually in the area and identify all the things you think the community needs, and after done all the five, you share your research with who? So you make a small presentation like I did now. Actually, you can download this and you can use this presentation in your church or in your club or whatever, because it's available. You just need to change a few things on it and it will be okay to be used. And present it to the church. Unbelievable things are happening. I'm telling you, I'm going to share a few of them with you. I believe in the power of example. So in the church are different kinds of people, but there are different kinds of people. So one of those is the ones which are really involved in all the activities, and you see their faces all the time. They are involved everywhere, you can see them. There are some which help, but they are not visible. Right, so maybe they can't be physically there, but they can help with money or other stuff. And there are people who don't do anything and then just point and complain all the time that the things which are done are not done correctly. Now, I strongly believe that you, if you are one of those who are in the first category, you can make the church working as they never did before. And believe me, God will work through you and through your church to do unbelievable things. Okay, so results. We did all the research. I'm going to share with you the two examples. One, this is simple. This is just one of the things which happened in London. There were loads of things happening in the same time in different parts of London. And I just loved it. It was great. It was a great experience. And I will talk about it with pleasure every time I have the chance to do it. So I'm going to share with you something which became to be known as the Sabbath sofa. And it started from a little thing. A woman was in a coffee shop and she was just needing rest.
No matter where you go, you find that people are tired. The stress of daily life can be overwhelming. We created the Sabbath sofa to introduce to people the idea that they can rest each and every week. Our last two adventures took place at Marble Arch and Soho in London. Take a look and see how the Sabbath sofa was received.
Hello, Sam. Shireen.
Hamida.
Hamida and Munna. What do you do for a living?
I'm in the Royal Marines.
Are you tired?
Yes, I am.
I don't know. I've been walking for a really, really long time.
What time did you start work?
I start at 3.
Commuting makes you tired.
The news makes me a little bit tired, but more than tired of listening
But news tired, like people, they say they are tired, but they should do something, like rather than complaining. I don't know.
I've done a lot of walking.
Okay.
And walking tires me out a lot.
All right. Okay. But you said you're tired mentally. Why are you tired mentally?
The things you see, the things you hear, the things you smell when you're out in Afghanistan, Iraq.
Oh, really? Have you been to Afghanistan?
Yes.
Wow. Okay, what about you? Anything else that gets you tired?
The evil in this world.
Wow. Now I'm looking for a new job because I've got no more energy to do it.
Sometimes watching the news, you do get bored, and then it reaches a point where for me, I just don't watch the news sometimes.
Right. Imagine with me, imagine that you could take 24 hours out of your life every single week. Let's just say from a Friday sunset to a Saturday sunset.
Okay.
And in that time, you could rest.
Amazing.
That sounds incredible.
Yeah?
Sounds like a dream.
A dream?
Come true.
Really?
Yeah.
I do need a day like that.
And it sounds like my own small world.
You need a day where you can just not think of anything, just relax, just and have a moment to like refresh yourself for the next day.
And it's a day that we just take time out to remember we were not designed to just keep going.
I think it's brilliant. Any time you can give to anybody, and to either it's from your time or money or whatever, if you just do good, it's perfect.
I'd like to challenge you today that for this coming week, whatever you're doing, to take some quality time out for yourself and for your family to rest. I'm really grateful you've come.
Me too, really. Very nice
sofa.
Thank
it's
you.
It's really nice that you could just hear about the Sabbath for yourself. I hope you get an opportunity to discover it for yourself.
I hope so, I really hope so.
You can see that people are eager for the Sabbath without even knowing it. The Sabbath sofa is just one of the many ways that you can witness to the people around you. How will you tell people about the good news of Jesus?
Okay. So, simple stuff. And the second one, which I said is coming from Dublin. And as you can see in this picture, in the first picture, there are so many youth. I'm telling you, the majority of them are Pathfinders in their Dublin Romanian Pathfinder Club. Some adults are there with them as well. And this is to answer the second need the community has in Dublin, which is food. Let me share the video with you.
Thank you.
I've shared with you on the last slide, you will find all the links to this video. As I said, there are people who are working in the background. So even if they are not on the street, they are in the background. They are preparing the packages. They are preparing the food for the homeless or for the people who need them. And of course, we start and we finish with a prayer. Okay, so we are approaching the end of this presentation. I hope you enjoyed, guys. Now, I am going to ask you, after all the examples presented today, can your club answer to any of the community needs? Can you do something from your community? And if yes, what would you think you can do for your community? Write it down in the chat, please.
Bogdan who is asking a question. Are there any needs that your club and you as a Pathfinder or adventurer or leader can address? So please do use your comment section for that, as and then I will share those with Bogdan as they come in. Bogdan, we don't wait for those answers, because for a long time they didn't write. Maybe they are not so much active at the moment. If it's possible, Bogdan, is there any other questions after this one, or is this the last one?
No, those are the last questions. I want our Pathfinders to know is that as Pathfinders, we have about, I think there are five or six honors who has to do only with community. So I'm going to send to you, Dejan, a link where they can check it afterwards. So if you are going to post everything on the Facebook, they can find them there. So additional to this this honor, there are another four or five which are dealing with the community. So there is stuff you will be doing or you are already doing, and you can get an honor for that because you're doing it from your heart. It's not that great. Okay, Pastor Diane.
Thank you so much, Bogdan, for this. In the meantime, we got some answers from Nabeha, who said, yes, especially in the time of COVID, we can definitely, as a club, so Pathfinders, address many needs. Pam Catchpole, our next presenter, actually said food parcels, clothes, collection and distribution, especially some people are volunteering during the vaccinations as well, just to let you know, to as the wardens on the car parks of the GP surgeries or areas. And then we have Romeo, which wrote a message as well. And many beautiful, good ideas. He said, helping to do things that people can't do, for example, litter picking and cleaning and many other things. Yeah. So well done to everybody. Bogdan, thank you so much for the presentation. And